Hello, I'm Philip Brunelle, Artistic Director and Founder of Vocal Essence and Organist Choirmaster at Plymouth Congregational Church in Minneapolis. Each day I have selected a different composer, one who has had a role to play at both organizations. And today it is a grand person from English music, C.H.H. Parry, really known as Charles Hubert Hastings Parry, who was a composer, a teacher, a historian of music, and an enthusiastic sailor, one of the only, maybe the only composer who was a member of the Royal Yacht Squadron. So Parry, in addition to his compositions, was also engaged by Charles Groves, a name that is associated with English history, music history, to write articles for the Groves Dictionary of Music. And Parry wrote 123 articles for that Groves Dictionary. From 1895 until 1918, when he passed away, he was the head of the Royal College of Music. Among his students were some names like Vaughan Williams, Holst, Bridge. He was an amazing man. People said that he was, of course, very busy doing that administrative work, and they wished maybe if he had not done that, he would have even composed more. But he did compose a lot of music. We're going to focus on his vocal music because it's beautiful music. Some of you may know his name because there is a famous anthem that he wrote, Words from the Psalms, which has been sung at every coronation ever since it was composed in the early part of the 1900s. And it's called I Was Glad When They Said Unto Me, and it has this grand orchestra introduction. Chorus comes in singing, I Was Glad, has a little section in the middle that we here in the USA don't ever sing. That's because it says in the music here, it is to be sung when the queen or king is present. Since that hasn't happened for us, we make that little cut that Parry asks for. So Parry also, of course, wrote a piece based on words of John Milton, called Blessed Pair of Sirens, which the ensemble singers have performed. And he, of course, wrote those beautiful songs of farewell. These were pieces, he wrote them just in the last year of his life. And a set of poems, one of them that I find particularly beautiful, a poem of Henry Vaughan that says, My soul, there is a country far beyond the stars. And it begins with this beautiful set of notes. Then he contrasts that thought. The next words say, there above noise and danger, sweet peace sits crowned with smiles. And listen to this contrast. Parry was also, of course, known for these kind of wonderfully grand moments. He wrote a number of big oratorios, and I'm very pleased today that Lisa Drew, that wonderful mezzo, is going to join me to sing a piece that comes from a much larger work. It's a piece called Judith, and it's an oratorio that just simply is never done. Well, there's lots of reasons. It has to do with an Old Testament story and lots of warfare and angst and all of that. But in the middle is this beautiful moment in which the character, and I love her name, Meshulameth, calls her children together and says, "May I tell you about our past? May I tell you about when the Israelites crossed the Red Sea, the waters parted?" And so she recalls that moment. And this melody that you will hear Lisa sing then and later became one of the most beloved of all hymns in England, and one that we at Plymouth Church sing as often as I can make sure that it's heard. So this is music from Judith, and it is this aria, "Long Since in Egypt's Plenteous Land." Music of C.H.H. Parry. Have a wonderful day.